Welcome, welcome, welcome. So I'm here to take any of your questions to help you on your detox journey. So if you have any questions, this is the time to ask. Okay, I'm gonna wait for a few minutes for people to join. Hello, everybody. Welcome. Welcome. So if you have any questions, please feel free and ask. Let's get this started. I know a lot of people have questions, and I want to make this very efficient and quick. Hello. Hello, hello. Welcome. Thank you so much. Thank you, thank you. Okay, yeah, I take ginger tea every morning. Yeah, that's fantastic. Ginger tea is fantastic. Increases digestion, increases circulation. It's fantastic herb altogether. Absolutely. Make sure it's fresh ginger though, okay? Let's see, what kind of water is good to drink? The water I prefer to drink is distilled water for the very simple reason that it excludes pharmaceuticals. All other waters, they have pharmaceuticals in it, and this can disrupt your hormones, etc. So I like distilled water for that reason. And also, it's the purest water you can find, okay? So distilled water. OOG, Goku, thank you so much for your kind words. I appreciate it. Hi, Jenny. Jenny SM. Education on ginger. Ginger is very, it's very, very powerful, very simple plant. Okay, when I say simple, I mean it has so many uses. Okay, but what it's used for primarily is for circulation, for digestion. Okay, when you combine it with other herbs, it even has more power. I like ginger tea because it can stop nausea as well. All around perfect herb to use. Okay. It's one of those herbs where it goes with almost everything, so it's a good addition to your herbal protocols. Is it possible to heal without herbs, just green and fruit juices? Yes, absolutely. This is for you. I think BLICCEDOUT. Yeah, absolutely. You can use that for sure. The herbs are important though, because the herbs, they're there to strengthen the structure and function of cells. That's what they're there for, and they make a big difference. Okay, very, very, very huge difference. But if you can't afford it, or you don't want to use the herbs, by all means, go ahead and use it. Someone asked me, what's your opinion on seaweed wraps for healing? I'm presuming that you mean the like nori wraps where you wrap veggies and eat it. It's fine. It won't stop your detox, and it's great for, has a lot of minerals and vitamins, and it's great for it's great for your thyroid as well. So yeah, absolutely. Don't use it if you have a hyperthyroid situation though. Okay, let me see. So what I would like to know what to take. Angie says, I would like to know what to take for brittle nails and thinning hair. Angie, brittle nails, okay, it means your parathyroid is weak. Your endocrine glands are weak, but more specifically your parathyroid. That's the gland that makes use of calcium. So when you have loose skin, hernias, varicose veins, brittle nails, this is your parathyroid. It often also means that your pituitary gland is weak, and also your thyroid is weak. So I would address that, okay? For thinning hair, it's mucus in the head region. Your body is highly acidic, and your gut is congested with lymph, so it's interstitial lymphatic congestion. And so the acids are backing up in your head region, and they're affecting tissue, organ, and glands, and especially the hair follicles in this case. It's also acids affecting the hormones, which affect your hair loss and hair growth phases. Okay, so you want to make sure you detox the whole body. Focus on your kidneys and your lymphatic system, because it's actually a kidney and lymph issue. Clean the bowels. Use herbs for circulation. Okay, we have it on our site called Circulation 1 and 2. Okay, and Neurological 1 as well. It helps boost blood flow to the region. Very powerful stuff. But as you can see, it's all interconnected, because you can see when one part is affected, the other part follows suit. So fix the parathyroid as well. Fix all the endocrine glands. Push blood flow to the head region, clean the gut, work on the kidneys and lymphatic system, and you see you get better. You can also add some green drinks in there to give you extra vitamin and minerals you need for your hair to grow. I am Karina. Says, what herbs can I give my son for seizure? So when it comes to seizure, this is a neurological issue, okay? And it's directly affect adrenals, directly affect this. So it most likely has adrenal issues. And if you look closely in his eyes, you probably see rings going around. We call them nerve rings. It indicates very weak nervous system, so weak adrenals, but also his gut may be congested. The solar plexus are there, and that controls nervous system function, as well as the back of the head, which is very, very, very likely and more likely in his case, because you have seizures. So you have, remember, the mastoid medulla back here, cerebellum is back here as well. And so if you have mucus in the head region, it's going to affect the function of your nervous system. So for this scenario, what I would do if it were me, of course, you know, go see your doctor and make sure you're on appropriate treatments. But to do it naturally, to heal naturally, I would be on 100% fruit, a high berry diet, because these are electric foods. They kind of kickstart the whole the nerves. That's what you need. And then you want to use herbs for the neurological brain and nerves. You call it neurological one. Use circulation herbs for the blood flow to the head region. Clean the gut. The head sits on a GI tract, so you want to make sure that the gut is clean. Get a kidney to filter. There's a kidney issue. Fix the lymphatic system. Give endocrine glands, work on the pituitary gland. Could be the pituitary gland issue controlling, because it controls the other endocrine glands, okay? And I would use antispasmodic herbs. I'll use them probably every hour or two, just to control the nerves, okay? So antispasmodic, you know, we call it calm, spasms and calm on our website. And I would use that every hour or so, just to calm things down, you know? And that's how you clean the body, okay? The nervous system, you gotta work on your adrenals, your solar plexus, the gut, and the mucus in the head region. Clean the head out. Hello, hi. Weight loss recipes for foods or juices. The fruit diet is the best diet for weight loss, period. Number one, because it's low in calories, right? Number two, it cleans out the glands that affect weight loss. For instance, if you can't lose weight, then it's your adrenals and thyroid. And there's no other food you can eat that's going to help remove the mucus and acids affecting the thyroid and the adrenals. So I would go on a fruit cleanse, maybe like a 20-day dark grape only cleanse, and I would use herbs for the adrenals, herbs for the thyroid. I'll clean up all my endocrine glands, including the pituitary gland. I would also, because the pituitary gland controls the thyroid, and the hypothalamus also controls the thyroid, so you gotta make sure those are in good order. Get an eye reading is very important. And 100% fruit diet, that's what I would use. The dark grape only diet is fantastic, and you will drop weight. If you target the adrenals and you target the thyroid, as well as the kidneys and the lymphatic system and the bowels, you will lose weight, okay? The only reason why you can't lose weight is because those things are compromised. Let's see. Well, how do you do the lemon detox? The lemon detox, let me go over it again, because it's one of my favorite tools of detoxification, a lemon only cleanse, okay? So you're gonna squeeze 3 to 5 lemons for a meal, and you're gonna replace all your meals, okay, with lemons, nothing but lemons. You drink the lemon undiluted, okay, 3 to 5 lemons. Some of you may not be able to do it, especially if you're highly toxic, it's not good for you, so you should transition. You should always go on a transition, meaning that have green drinks and salads, okay, for a week or two, and then add sub-acid fruits, and then work yourself to the lemon only cleanse, because it's a kicker, okay? It's a very, very powerful cleanse. And some people, if you're really toxic, it's going to give you detox symptoms that like headaches and cold and flu-like symptoms that you may not enjoy too much. So always transition to it, and keep it at for initially a 7-day to 10-day lemon only cleanse is more than enough for most people, at least. If you want to really detox the body at a deep level, then you prolong it. But I would recommend that you at least try for 7 to 10 days and see how you feel, and then take a break, and then maybe do a longer version of it. So lemon only cleanse basically is just replacing all your meals. And when I say all your meals, I mean including beverages like coffees or any snacks kind of thing. Should be all raw, of course, but in your lemon only cleanse, you eat nothing but lemons, in juice it, sorry. And that's how you do the lemon only cleanse. Very simple, very powerful. If you need, and make sure you do use the herbs, okay? It's very important in this regard, because, I mean, you're sacrificing the time and the effort to do a lemon only cleanse. Make sure you use the Fabulous Five, at the very least, and the kidney tea, okay? Let's see what we do here. And we got quite a few questions here. Oh, thank you so much for the kind words. I appreciate you guys being here. I'm so happy to be here to help you. Let's get more, quite a few questions. I want to sort and get good ones here. How can I get my hair back since a year I have alopecia universalis? Loss of all body hair. If you have alopecia, it's an autoimmune, so-called autoimmune issues. Basically means you have high inflammation in the whole body. Your lymphatic system is compromised. Okay, there's no way of actually treating it successfully, because this is if the lymph system is compromised, all your glands are compromised, and it just makes things worse. So if you want to fix this, get relief on this, you need to go on a 100% fruit diet. I would choose my favorite, a dark grape only cleanse, maybe a 30-day dark grape only cleanse, and I would use herbs two kidney formulas, two kidney Ts, two kidney lymphatic formulas, work on the adrenals, work on the bowels, work on the endocrine glands. It's going to take a bit of time because this is chronic. But for the hair, use circulation tinctures to boost blood flow to the scalp, clean the gut, clean all the sinuses, make sure there's no mucus in the head region, do ear candling, blow your nose properly, do eye washes, anything to break the mucus in the head region that's holding up acids and affecting tissue organ and glands in the head region, especially the follicles. You want to make sure you get rid of those, okay? Let's see. And we have quite a few questions here. Let me see. So the next question is, I covered the ginger tea already. Let's see, I kind of missed a few questions here. What's wrong? What's wrong when I can't absorb water? It runs through me. Oh, wow. Okay. Usually, water is used, apart from the fact that your body needs it, it's used as a buffering agent. So I can't see why water will run through you. I mean, work on your, alkalize the body. I wouldn't use water at this point, actually. I would use green drinks and I'll use fruit juices. See, water, even though is the nature's greatest solvent, it's not the best when it comes to detoxing, because when your body is highly acidic, your body will retain water in the form of edema to protect you, tissue, organ, and glands, okay? And consuming a lot of water, the body, it's hard on the kidneys. It really is, because the kidney has to take care of the water. And so I would go on fruit juices and see how you react. I wouldn't drink too much. I'll get grapes and chew them properly, and then I'll have some grape juice or any kind of freshly squeezed fruit juices and see how I respond to that. But I'll work on my kidneys and my lymphatic system, because this is a sign of acidity that you want to you want to take care of. Let's see. I my opinion, distilled water is better than spring water, because you see, unlike most people who think that you get minerals from your water, if it's a natural occurring spring water, different story. You might drink it, is okay, but remember that inorganic minerals are not designed for the human body. They're designed for plants and fruits, basically to fruit trees to use. And when we consume the fruits and veggies, we get the minerals, but this time it's bioavailable. Consuming inorganic material is not a good idea, okay? Because it's hard on the system. So contrary to what people might tell you, your water is important, but it's not going to save you. Drinking alkaline water, high pH water, is not actually a good solution, because for you to alkalize a cell, you need nutrients. You can't just alkalize with water. You might actually experience alkalosis if you're taking really high pH water. So I wouldn't do that. Someone says, well, what can I do to strengthen eyes? To strengthen eyes, it's clean the head and the sinuses and clean the gut, because your head sits on your GI tract. I always say this to you. And if your GI tract is congested, if there's mucus in the, if your lymph system is not moving properly in the gut, acids can't drain out properly. And there's like a block of energy flow in and out of the body. Sorry, there's no flow of energy, no flow of lymph flow, blood flow, and nerve flow. Or there's a compromise of it. Okay, so when you start to have eye issues, it means mucus in the head region, and the acids are burning tissue, organ, and glands. So you want to drain the acids out of the head region. So you want to, number one, clean the sinuses. Do everything you can to clean them. Okay, ear candling, like I always mention, eye washes, and then you want to do neurolymphatic massages at the back of the head, some cold compresses at the back of the head. You chew horseradish root to help break the mucus. Use a neti pot with peppermint oil or eucalyptus oil. These help break the sinuses. And number two, you want to clean the gut, so use herbs for the bowels. Number three, use eye washes. I just mentioned already, they have stuff like bilberry in there for the eye, to wash the eye and to sense blood flow and moves the lymph system for you. It's a great way of nurturing. It's called, in our site, it's called Sight Eyes, and it has great herbs in there for the eyes, okay, to boost blood flow to the head region as well. You want to also use a neurological one tincture. It strengthens the nervous system of the head region, and circulation herbs to push blood flow to the head region. And that's how I would deal with it, and give it time, of course. But I would be on in your scenario, a 20-day Dagrip only diet. Elizette, sorry. Yeah, you said you're on 7 days of grapes only and melon. Wow, that's fantastic. Congratulations to you. Should you add another fruit? No, absolutely. If you are fine with the 7-day grape and melon, it's fantastic. It's one that you're using two of the most powerful two of the most powerful fruits, okay? And add the herbs in there, you are flying. Okay, so let's see. How, Just for Haley, ask how long have you been detoxing for? Haley, I don't detox on a consistent basis. Detoxification is a misunderstood term. When you, it's a natural process that the body goes through on a daily basis if you're consuming the right foods. Okay, so when you go on a detox, it's used loosely. Your body naturally tries to detox itself, but when you consume protein and starches, that is compromised and you cannot detox anymore. The liver is not a detoxifier in the sense of getting rid of metabolic waste. It does transmute chemicals, but it's not going to save you. Okay, so a lot of people say, well, my liver detoxes, why should I detox? Well, because you're eating garbage, you're eating protein and starches, you have mucus and acids all over the glands, the liver can't function properly, you're not eliminating waste through the bowels, through the kidneys, and then everything gets congested and there's a block of energy flow and you start getting health issues. This is how it works in natural healing, how we see it, okay? And you only have to go on a fruit cleanse to understand. But having said that, I'm not on constant detox mode. On most days, I will try and be 100% fruit, but not always. So I'm not in the process of detoxing anything in particular at this point. Although I do like to do an occasional burst of detoxification, like I'll try a 2 or 3 week fruit only diet, not because I need to do it, but because I like to practice what I preach. And I feel fantastic when I do it, but I'm not a fruitarian and it's not a lifestyle for me. My average diet on a regular basis is 70% fruits, 30% raw veggies and some cooked vegan. And I occasionally do have cheat meals in there, which are like vegan Indian food, vegan Chinese, all those so-called bad foods. Well, on occasion I will have them, okay? I'm not a purist, a Puritan. And my diet is not by all means not perfect, but I do like to be on 100% food for most of the days if I'm able. And plus, I will add some dry fasting. So the question of how long do I detox for is I don't really detox, but it's more of a lifestyle change for me. But I'm not always on 100% fruits. I hope that helps you. And likewise, when you heal yourself, and you can also add balance to your life, adding veggies in there and cook vegan, alkaline vegan. Okay. Manji says my bone cracks too much. Manji, if your bones are cracking, it's a sign of acidity. The body will leach calcium out of tissue when it's trying to buffer acids, metabolic waste. And so as it takes acids out of your system, you have this bone cracking. Okay, so it's a sign of dehydration, cellular dehydration. It's a sign that your whole body needs is to the acidic side. So you need to hydrate and alkalize the body, okay, with 100% fruits and the herbs. I would also work on the parathyroid because parathyroid is what makes use of calcium. If it's weak, you're going to have an issue. Fix the kidneys, okay, because the kidneys don't filter out. You can't remove the waste. And this waste will start drawing calcium from bone and destroying the bone matrix. You see, your blood will start showing a lot of phosphorus and potassium and calcium, and then basically you're eroding the bones away. So get the kidneys to filter, fix the lymph system, work on the endocrine glands, clean the bowels, and use the parathyroid glandular or herbs, and you should be good to go. Okay. Matt interrupted says how. What steps do you take to make the transition from a regular diet to a raw diet, please? Matt, I went to a raw vegan retreat, okay? I used to be a heavy, heavy, heavy meat eater. I eat meat in every single meal. I was taking protein supplements. I was doing about 1 to 2 grams of protein per pound of body weight, which is astronomical. And I was weightlifting a lot. And this led to a lot of joint issues, a lot of fungal issues. And according to a doctor, I was pre-diabetic. But, it all changed for me when I went to a raw vegan retreat. I was there for 3 weeks and completely transformed my life and my health and my body. And I've never looked back ever again. All my pains went away. Okay. All my aches and pains and muscle pains went away. So that's how I made a transition. It was cold turkey. Okay. No pun intended. Let's see. We have quite a few. Bad breath. Bad breath is your gut. You smell like what you eat. If your gut is congested and you are holding putrid proteins and starches in the bowel walls, are stuck from eating the wrong foods for years, you're going to smell, your breath is going to smell. And the way to get rid of it is to cleanse the putrid stuff in your gut. So you need to cleanse the bowel, use herbs for the bowels. We have something called bowel strength tincture. It helps you strengthen the bowels. And use the bowel cleanser. It scrapes the mucus plaque on the small intestines and removes all those offending putrid matter that's causing the bad breath. apologize again. So you have to change your diet. You smell like what you eat. If you really want to accelerate this, go on dry fasting. Try 24 to 36 hour dry fast. Okay, don't try the 36 hour until you're actually, I've done several 24 hour ones. And be on the fruit diet at the same time. Use the herbs as I mentioned, and the bad breath will go. If you do it properly, your breath will smell sweet. Okay, and your tongue also, it'll be white. It will turn, it will cake out. You see a lot of white, and that shows your lymph condition of your lymph system in the gut and entire body for that matter. And it will turn a pink, okay, very clear pink if you do it correctly and long term. It takes a bit of time, but when it turns pink, your breath will start smelling nice. And when you eat the fruits, you smell like the fruits. It's very true. You just have to try it and see. Okay. Can you talk about hair loss? Yes, hair loss is, I just mentioned briefly, but I'll do it quickly again. If you have hair loss, it's acidosis, okay, of the entire body, systemic. But your weakest link is your head region. There's a lot of mucus accumulated there. And this mucus will affect the hair follicles. But also, you have mucus affecting your hormones, which can also cause you hair loss. So change your diet, number one. Number two, use herbs for the entire body. The Fabulous Five, you know, as I always mention to you, the basic, you all know it. If you follow me, you know it, Fabulous Five and the kidney tea, these are your basis. And you want to use circulation herbs called circulatory one and neurological one. And you want to clean the gut and you want to use a hair oil. You know, we have one, it's called grow hair oil. You put it on your scalp. It's going to push blood flow to your scalp and you give it a little time. Okay. Remember that the body will get rid of weak tissue. The reason why you're losing hair because the body doesn't want it anymore. The hair is literally weak. It's weak, tissue. The body gets rid of it. Nature's law, remember, is the weak are eliminated and the strong survive. So even when you're detoxing, sometimes, not always though, you might end up losing more of the hair initially because the body won't keep it. It doesn't want it. It's weak. Okay, you don't build a strong house on a weak foundation. You need a strong foundation. So the body gets rid of weak tissue and then it rebuilds again. And then you have nice, beautiful hair growing up again. And it's strong and it will never fall off once you do it properly. I see. Okay, I covered thinning nails. What to take for thinning nails? Thinning nails, you're working your parathyroid and your endocrine glands, okay? So very simple. Hernias, again, it's a parathyroid gland. Again, acidity, high acidity in the body steals calcium from tissue, bones, etc., and actual tissue itself, and it weakens it, and this can cause hernias. So you want to make sure your body's alkalized, so eat high alkaline foods, you know, and then use the herbs and for endocrine glands, clean the bowels, kidneys, and lymphatic system. This is kidney and lymphatic system, always kidney and lymphatic system. Work on the adrenals. And like I mentioned, maybe take an a parathyroid glandular. If you look at, do an eye reading, you will see the parathyroid. If it's chronic and it's dark, then I would use a parathyroid glandular to kickstart the gland for maybe a month and then use other herbs to support it as well. Lymph system. You're funny. I don't know the word you're using, but you're funny. Okay. Someone says, you said no seaweed for hyperthyroid. Yeah, whenever you have a hyper case, okay, it doesn't matter where it is, hyper tissue, you never want to stimulate activity in the gland or organ because the cells are already generating waste that you cannot get rid of. And when you stimulate it, then you are you are increasing, you're creating more waste, which the body can't get rid of in the first place. So it makes things a lot worse. And FYI, if you have a hyper situation, it often turns into a hypo. I mean, they're interchangeable. They go back and forth and rotate between each other. But if you have a hyper situation, I would use the seaweed to stimulate the thyroid. But if you're on a hyper, I wouldn't use any direct stimulation. What you do need to do though is get the lymph system moving and clean the kidneys and work on the adrenals. This is actually endocrine issue. It's very likely it's your pituitary gland. It's very likely it's your hypothalamus because they control your thyroid. So you got to focus on that. I would advise you get an eye reading to see which glands or tissue is actually weak. Okay. Jay Hendrick says, so you can't just go bald naturally and be healthy. it's not that you can't be healthy, okay? That everybody has their own genetic weaknesses and strengths. For instance, some people have their acid expressed in their head region and lose hair, but yet they're very strong with their kidneys and very strong with their liver. So if the kidneys are strong and the lymph system is strong, you are healthy, technically speaking, right? But the question is, how long can you keep it? And also, those genes and those weak lymphatic system and weak kidneys are going to be transferred to your offspring if you intend to have any offspring. And they will have, not only will they have hair loss issues, but they're also going to have kidneys and lymphatic issues because you thought you were indestructible and kept on eating the wrong foods, thinking that you pay no price, but then your offspring pays the price. So absolutely, you can eat the most crappiest foods, and if you have a very strong genetic constitution, you will be fine. You can see some people who are 90 years old, they've been smoking all their life. You cannot use that though as your a benchmark that you are the same. You're not the same, because everybody's different. And some people have really, really strong genes, especially the old timers, okay? But today's generation, the younger ones, I've read thousands of eyes, thousands, and without exception, especially for the youngest ones, if you're 25 and younger, you have horrible adrenals, horrible lymphatic system, horrible kidneys. The eyes show it clearly. And today, if you look around, the kids all have a lot of issues, skin issues, thyroid issues, kidney issues. It's almost shocking, to say the least. So I would not base my health on the fact that Mr. Jones down the street there lived to 100 and was bald, or he didn't get any sickness. Mr. Jones had superior genetics, perhaps, than myself. So I would not bet on myself based on Mr. Jones's genes, okay? I hope that answers your question. Having said that, this body is only a temporary vehicle we are driving. No one lives forever, everything. But you got to make your own judgment. Would you rather take a chance and be healthy or be old and sick? It's up to you how you want to direct the car, the vehicle of your life. That's your body. Okay. How to detox the uterus. Remember that the uterus, red roses is for you. Uterus, whatever it is, any kind of organ, gland, is simply made out of cells. It could be bone. It's still made up of cells. And in every cell, there's two major fluids. There's the lymphatic system, lymph fluid, and there's the blood. Blood feeds, lymph removes the waste. Okay. And it doesn't matter what the location, if it's uterus, that means you are not eliminating waste properly through in the uterine region, okay, in the female reproductive area, because your kidneys are not filtering. So you do have a kidney filtration issue, and you gotta fix that, and you gotta move the lymph system, because if you don't, the acids will accumulate, and you start having issues in the uterus, which, trust me, you don't want. So go on a fruit cleanse, use the herbs, and stay consistent, and use herbs for the female reproductive area. And use herbs to push blood flow to the region. Maybe do a douche with lymphatic herbs, cleanse the area, and you will thrive. You do very well there, okay? Okay, Royal Mo says lymph nodes. Okay, lymph nodes in the groin. I've been fruits for 2 months now. Can't seem to get rid of swollen nodes. remember that for most people, especially when it comes to lymph nodes that are swollen, it can take you a long time. Okay, very often people will wait until it gets too hard, and surgically has to be removed. But remember, anything that gets hard. Okay, what is it telling you? It's hard like a rock. Okay, and that means the acid is so high, it's dried it out, almost like a stone. Do you know how long it takes to break that down? Okay, I mean, just, you have to move the lymph system, you have to eventually dissolve it, and that can take time. 2 months is not enough time. For most people, 2 months is not enough for dissolving hardened lymph nodes, okay? You have to work harder. You have to use lymphatic herbs. If you have kidney filtration, I would use a lymphatic tincture and hit it hard with that, maybe 3 to 5 times a day. If you have any, that's only if you have kidney filtration. If you don't have kidney filtration, I would work on my kidney filtration and move the lymph system with the fruits. But I would also use a castor oil packs on the location just to soften it up a bit for you. But yeah, it can take some time. 2 months is nothing, especially for that scenario. Someone said, is Naked brand juice good? No, if you buy any brand of juice from a store, I don't care if it's cold pressed, it's not good, because by the time it hits the shelf, Most of them are pasteurized, and even if it's cold pressed, it's probably a day or two old. So you're paying $9 to $10 for a bottle of juice that's giving you no nutrients. If you go and buy $10 worth of oranges, you get triple the amount of juice, and it's healthy and it's all alive and electrical for you. So do not buy bottled juices unless you absolutely have to and you're stuck in a situation where you have no other option and you have a cold pressed juice, then you can have it, but don't make it a habit. Yeah, thank you for the kind words. I do appreciate it. Can the Master Cleanse heal the bad breath? Yes, the Master Cleanse is like the lemon only cleanse. My version though is more potent. The Master Cleanse, basically you dilute the water and you put maple syrup in there and a pinch of cayenne pepper. The undiluted is far more superior because it's more concentrated. So, but yes, this is what I would use for the bad breath. And I would use the bowel cleanser and the bowel strength tincture to help scrape the mucus plaque that's causing the bad breath. Okay, and fix the whole gut area. Fix them. Is this a kidney and lymphatic issue? Conscious Nate says, have you ever gone through releasing intense emotions during food detox? Conscious Nate, I didn't go through emotional detox because I resolved my mind. Okay, I went through intense meditation that most people would not even possibly comprehend, and doing that as young as I can remember, actually. Even as young as a child, I was doing it. As young as five to 6 years old, I was meditating on my own accord. So I've gone to deep levels of meditation that most people would not ever even come close to touching. Okay, and in during that process, you see all your emotions, all your so-called levels of in the human body come out, and it can be scary sometimes. But I confronted them all. Okay, and this is what everybody's here for. You're supposed to come here to find who you really are. If you think you're just here for a finite period of time to eat and sleep and then repeat, then you are sadly mistaken. You are here to find who you truly are, your true being. And it's, I can tell you straight out, it's not your body or mind for that matter. You're far, far beyond this, far bigger than you can ever imagine. That's why you should never always try and be detached from everything you do or in this world, and don't have too strong desires or fears, because actually the fear and desire are one and the same thing. But I didn't go through the emotional detox because I went through it before I ever came across the raw vegan diet. Okay, I hope that helps. But if you want a book to show you the right direction of where to go to find yourself, then please reach out to me. I'll direct you. This is a good question. Can fruits and herbs dramatically help with the brain neural pathways for reconnecting or new connections? Absolutely. Absolutely. Without a question. There's no other food on the planet that can spark up the nervous system for you than fruits. Not even close. Veggies don't even come close to the fruits. Yeah, you can only compare and see the difference. But I would use neurological herbs, in there. Like in our website, we have something called Neurological One Tincture. Very powerful. Use that. Okay, and it helps you spark your nerves. But yeah, 100% fruit diet, grape only, berry only diet, fantastic for sparking up the nerves. Okay, you gotta clean the lymph system. Okay, remember that when you have neurological issues, your lymph system is pressing on the nervous system and it's eroding it, and the acids are eroding it. So you want to make sure that all the pathways are open. So fix the kidneys, fix the lymph system, and send blood flow to the head region, work on the endocrine glands, and you can do very well. Okay, you might need a bit of time, but you're gonna feel the effects almost quite recent. I mean, be quick. Someone says, what are your opinions on colonics? Colonics, once in a while is okay. I wouldn't do it on a regular basis, like on a daily basis or like every two day basis. No, I would use enemas instead because they're gentler. Colonics are really strong, and you use high pressured waters, etc. And so you don't want to do it too often. Okay, once in a while is good. Give it a nice cleanse. But there's something called a colema board, which is far superior than enema. But it can be done at home. You have to buy the whole thing. It's like $300. And then there's enemas. These are, in my opinion, better for you because they're gentler. But the colonics, I'll have it once in a while. Yeah, absolutely. Okay. Nubian Princess, hello. How you doing? Shushu Lover, thank you for kind words. I appreciate you being here as well. Thank you so much. Okay. Let's see. IDOG, should I wait for my eye reading to buy more products? Yes, IDOG, yes. Your eye reading will be ready soon, okay? It'll be extensive, so you can see everything in there. No problem at all. Just be patient. In the next couple of days, you'll get it. Let's see. Yeah, oh, this video, this is always recorded. So when I'm done, I will save it on the live so you can watch it again, okay? Yeah, I'm sorry. Someone says, I ordered your kidney tea. Can I start the lemon detox with it? Yes, absolutely. Start the lemon. Make sure you transition first, though. I don't know if you're already on fruits. But if you're already on fruits, you can jump to lemon detox. If not, then transition for a few days with the green drinks and salads before you do so, okay? Okay. Let's see. More question. Can you eat too much fruit? I've not been able to, let's put it that way. I've never heard anyone doing so either. If you go on a 100% food diet and you cleanse the body properly and clean the small intestines, you don't even get hungry. So you will not get to the point of overeating. You only overeat when you're malabsorbed or you're depressed or something like that. But I mean, on a fruit cleanse, when you cleanse the body properly, you don't get hungry at all. So you don't eat much. And plus, you're eating high nutrient dense foods, and the foods are providing all the nutrients you need. Whereas if you eat protein and starches, it's dead food. The nutrients in there are not as much, and therefore you have to eat a lot of it. So you always have that bulky, full feeling that makes you feel unhealthy. Okay. So I would avoid that. Okay. Okay. More questions. Someone says, I can, oh, let's see what we need. Someone says, I've been passing my bowels like 2 to 3 times a week. I purchased, okay, your bowel cleanser, one bag. Will this help to clean? If you are constipated, I would use the bowel strength tincture because it helps remove your bowels. I would also use a lot of green drinks and fruit juices temporarily, because if you're constipated and you're eating solid foods like protein starches, you're adding more congestion into the pathways, and it's already obstructed. So you're adding more. You don't need fiber in this stage if you're that constipated. Because going to the washroom twice a week is very bad. Okay, you should have a bowel movement for most people after every meal, not directly, but after a few hours after every meal. Okay, so use a bowel strength tincture. I would use like 3 to 7 times until I get movement, and work on your adrenals, because adrenals control peristalsis. Okay. Someone says, can you heal viral issues with sarsaparilla? No. You can't, because the herbs don't work that way. Herbs are not for treating. Herbs are there to clean and strengthen cells. You cannot take a herb and say it's going to get rid of my issue, because that's treatment thinking. This is not how herbs work. You use medication for that, and you go see a doctor for that. Okay. For herbs, the right way to use them is in conjunction with a cleanse. It could be dry fasting, water fasting, fruit juices, green drinks. Use the herbs to help you. And the sarsaparilla is a herb, so I would use the sarsaparilla with a fruit cleanse. I wouldn't use it with an animal product or cooked starch diet, because obviously it's evident that you have issues, right? So it doesn't heal something by itself. You have to put it with the fruits, a detox program. Okay. Someone says, what can I do for a stuffy nose? I blow my nose all day, every day, my whole life. It's allergies. I'm vegan for 3 years now. Vegan, what kind of vegan though? Just because you're vegan doesn't mean that you're necessarily healthy, especially if you're eating cooked vegan food. Most of the cooked vegan foods out there, most of them are starches. Okay. So when you say vegan food, healthy vegan food, that's alkaline vegan, and there's very, very little starches in there at all, if any at all. And it's usually a lot of raw vegan stuff in there. That's a healthy vegan diet. But most people out there, especially if you look at influence people who have Instagram channels, and they're posting vegan dishes, they're all bad for you. Okay. The fake meats and the tofu and the soy products and everything, this is not a good food. This causes mucus congestion. But if you have a stuffy nose and you blow your nose all day, I would go on a lemon-only cleanse. I'll transition and go lemon-only cleanse and clean the sinuses. I have steps for it. Just DM me. I'll send to you. Use herbs for blood flow to the head region. Do everything you can to clean the sinuses. There are steps like ear candling, blow your nose, eye washes, you know, chew horseradish root, it breaks the mucus, use a neti pot. There's so many things you can do to break congestion in the head region. But clean the gut, very important. If you cannot get rid of this mucus in your head, so your gut is congested as well. But this is a heart, a kidney issue, and a lymphatic issue, so I would address that, okay? Yeah, that's what I would do. And allergies is a lymphatic issue. You fix your lymphatic system, your allergies will go away, okay? It's quite that simple, which means that your kidneys are not filtering. Thank you for the kind words. I appreciate you so much. Thank you. Gigi, please, Gigi Antonio, please reach out to me on direct message, okay? I'll help you. Let's see what we can do. Yeah, and does ear candle help with mucus in the head? Yes, it helps relieve the pressure and congestion, absolutely. I actually bought a new product. It's not an ear candle, but it's like a sprig gun, water, and you put it in your ear. It has like a little tool in there, and you press it, and it washes out. Kind of like when you go to the doctor and you clean your ears, he puts like a spray gun in your ear, and it pushes the mucus out. I found out better than ear candling. I'll make a video on it and show it to you so that you see, but it's very effective, okay? How do I get rid of mucus in the back of my throat? I deal with this on a daily basis. Mucus in the back of my throat. Okay, it's funny you bring this up because I 2 days ago I had I've been talking too much. I've been on Instagram. I've been on Instagram and all the social channels, and I do an hour live or hour and a half, and it really gets my throat because obviously I'm using it, right? It gets inflamed. So I used a day ago. I was really sore. I used a respiratory tincture. It has all the herbs, powerful herbs for the throat and the lungs. And I took it about, you know, 5 to 7 times a day. I kept on hitting it hard, and next day it's completely gone, okay? So you use the herbs, absolutely. But I would go and I'm only cleanse, use the respiratory tea, respiratory one tincture, clean the bowels, use all the herbs you need for the entire body, but focus on herbs for the respiratory system and the throat region. You see, you'll get relief. Let's see, any more questions? Oh, Alexan 456022. Thank you, you're welcome, man. Thank you for the kind words. You got your order, hit it hard, and you're gonna do well. Fruits and herbs, you do very well. You're gonna do very well. What can I use to remove chemical I got from expired IV? Okay, you took something into your system that you don't want it to be there. Okay, that's fine. Detox, 100% fruits and herbs, and give it time, that's it. Okay, that's the way you do it. Remember that the body will store poisons if it cannot remove the poisons to the extent. Obviously, if the poisons are really aggressive, then you're in trouble. But if the poisons are not that aggressive, it will store it in your lymphatic system, some part of it. And the only reason why it won't get rid of it and expel it to the outside world is because it can't release it properly through the kidneys, through the skin, through the lungs, through the bowels. So your job is to open up all four of the channels of elimination. And so 100% fruit diet and herbs. I would go on a lemon only cleanse and a dark grape only cleanse until I get relief, until it goes away. Okay, but make sure you use the herbs. It's very important. Vish 6666, thank you for the kind words, brother. I appreciate you. Thank you. Very kind of you. What can be used to balance testosterone and prolactin in women? If you want to balance your hormones, you have to understand that for most people, there's an excess amount of estrogen in our environment, from the foods we eat, from what we breathe, the perfumes, everything, and this can disrupt the hormone balance as well. Also, if your pituitary gland, your adrenals, and the ovaries are not in good form, what's going to happen is that you're going to have a hormone imbalance, and this will cause issues for you. But regardless of how you look at it, remember that everything has cells, and then everything is made up, has two fluids in the basic level, two fluids, blood and lymph. And it's a lymph congestion that's going to cause the problem. So you just have to cleanse the whole body and use herbs specifically for the adrenals, the ovaries, and the pituitary gland. These are the hormone so-called producers, as well as the liver, work on the liver as well. And you see, things will balance out. But you're going to 100% fruit cleanse and use herbs for the entire body, the fabulous five, the kidney tea, and extra herbs specific for those three parts I just mentioned. Okay. I covered the sinuses and lungs already. I also covered the question about too much fruits. I'll post it again, this video, so you can watch it, okay, the answers for that. Let's see. Okay. So what herbs will be good for fatty liver? For fatty liver, understand the root cause of it, okay? Most people are not telling you this, but the root cause of a fatty liver is acidosis. And specifically in your case, it's a weakness to the liver. The body will create fat because as a way of protecting the liver. So if you want to stop it, stop the acidosis that's causing the need for it. 100% fruits I would use. Add some green drinks in there and use herbs for the entire body, fabulous five kidney tea, and I use extra herbs for the liver. That's how I would address it, okay? If you don't get rid of the acidosis, the liver will accumulate more fat. Also, you can do dry fasting as well, 14 to 16 hour dry fast a day with the herbs afterwards and the diet. It will do you a lot of good. Okay. So someone says, do you only eat fruit and raw veggies? Do you eat other potatoes, bread, apple? I covered this already. I'll go over briefly again. My diet is 70% fruits. I'm not a fruitarian. Okay, I'm plant-based. I don't go by the term vegan, but I guess you would call it a vegan diet. But I do have occasional, yes, I do have occasional starches in my diet, absolutely. I mentioned that my cheating foods would be Indian food and Chinese food primarily. And also, because I'm from Africa, Ghana, West Africa, I like my starchy foods once in a while as well. But I don't make it a constant in my life. So my diet is predominantly, like I said, 70% fruits, 30% raw vegan slash cooked vegan, cooked alkaline vegan would be. And then on occasion, I will have those foods that are bad, so-called bad for you, okay? Like I mentioned before, I'm not a Puritan. I believe in balance. But I also believe that if you're in trouble, you want to heal yourself, don't touch any other foods but the fruits, okay? And I don't touch any meat. I've stopped touching meat for 9 years now, and I'll never look back at it. And the best decision I ever made. And I'm thankful for my wife for exposing this to me. I couldn't be more grateful. Okay, well, thank you so much again. I appreciate it, guys. I'll try and come back some other time. I love you guys. Thank you again. I'm talking to you specifically watching this, and I appreciate you being here. It means a lot to me that you take your time to learn this stuff. And you know, my goal is like is to help you so you can help other people, because a lot of people need help, and a lot of people don't know that there's a chance of healing themselves, because they give up. They listen to information on other avenues that make it impossible. I was the same way. Before I got exposed to this, I never thought that you could heal certain issues, but now I know how easy it is. My slogan has become fruits and herbs. Keep healing simple, always. Keep healing simple and fruits and herbs. I mean, it doesn't get any simpler than that. Even a child can learn it and apply, okay? So thank you so much, and thank you for the hearts. I appreciate it. It's all booming right now, and you have my heart to you. Thank you. I really, really appreciate you being here. And thank you for being you, and thank you for taking charge of your own health. You know, try and help other people, spread the message. No matter how small the message is, other person deserves to hear, at least be exposed to it. And you'll be doing good for yourself and others, and the good energy comes back to you a million times fold. Okay, good karma. Okay, so bless you, and have a wonderful, wonderful evening. Okay.